Actually, everyone always goes and looks on the other side. This is one of my favorites.
Well, I mean, it's got a better view of my
just they're getting there.
Told you it wouldn't be long.
Ah, gentlemen.
It wasn't long at all.
The Admiral's requested you, so I guess we'll get this thing started. I'll contact him and. Nope, you ready?
Right. What do you think this is about?
Well. Could be anything knowing the Admiral.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Got a lot more droids now.
Howdy, folks.
Quite nice.
Admiral?
Reprogrammed a few Imperial ones on the station. How are we doing?
Fantastic. Can't complain.
Feeling. Not much.
A7?
Seems like we have a glass half full and a glass half empty, huh?
Still riding that high.
Secret. They are the same glass.
Isn't that right?
I don't suppose that either of you have ever heard of a little rock out in the middle of nowhere called Ipasso.
Can't say I have.
No.
That's what I expect either of you to have. It's something of a historical site. An old ruin there. Ancient castle. No one lives on the planet. It's been uninhabited for something like 500,000 years. Used to be the interest of archaeologists at one time, but it's been picked pretty clean and hasn't had many visitors in the last 2,000 years. It's, I suppose, what you would call a forgotten place. Well, what's caught our eye is that a forgotten place is a useful location for us to meet.
Us being...
First Coalition Congress.
Huh.
Really?
It's come together that fast, huh?
How'd we pull that off?
Well, it wasn't any of my business. It's the, civilian leadership. Which is why you're here. The Congress has recognized both of you, yourself as the Sovereign Prince of Altu and Prince Claimant of Onderon. You've been recognized by the Congress as Sovereign Leaders, and you've both been invited.
Great.
Right.
Well,
you're believed
I
to be the best representatives
home.
Of your people. I don't suppose there'll be too much fuss about it. There are a lot of us who didn't bring our dresses with us. Although, unfortunately, I did decide to pack a dress uniform, which means I have to go put on that stuffy collar.
I don't envy you.
I don't.
Well, I'll be flying both of you out personally, since I know that neither of you are much of a pilot.
Thank you for that.
Wow.
Besides, I was heading that way anyway.
Business of your own type, or are we gonna be brushing shoulders?
Military committee.
Ah. Really is coming together.
Really is.
So, I'm gonna go switch out of comfortable duds, and I recommend that you do the same, Highness. And maybe you should comb your hair.
Well, they're lucky they got me to shave this morning.
They didn't get me to shave for about 30 years.
Is that about change?
Absolutely not. I have no facial hair regulations at the Coalition Congress. Take a second, get yourselves cleaned up. Get a change of clothes if you have them. I'll meet you on the flight deck. Say in about 5 minutes. Less than that. However, I can be ready in 3. See you, folks.
Right.
See you there.
So you're going to have to sign out for that crap that you're taking.
Yeah.
Good luck, gentlemen.
Hey, Captain.
I can't believe it.
Got some stones.
This is a big deal.
It is.
Planets haven't met for two decades.
It's a huge deal.
He said it's passed to women of considerable character, and so I asked him why he had it, and he didn't answer. But
well, I wasn't joking when I said I left my finery back home.
Kathy, that's funny.
It it's made me realize that I'm less of
we could figure something out.
Less of a a dead weight than I thought.
Just a second, Leo.
I can really pull my weight if I.
No, listen up.
Huh?
Yep.
Oh, cast me. Welcome back, kid.
Hey, Beers.
I hate to.
I know. I hate to rush the welcome backs, but I have to get ready. We're going to something important. Pell, you're in charge.
Alright, droid. Yeah, no worries.
Good. I'll see you on the flip and let you hear all about it.
Have a safe trip.
Will do.
Bye!
Come take care now.
One piece.
We will!
I'll miss you.
Damn kids.
Buy an arm.
If you have something I can borrow, I would appreciate it. But,
maybe another shirt. One less dirty.
Anything in red or black? Let's see, Honduranian royal colors.
Red or black?
May I ask you.
You know, I can't say.
What are your thoughts?
I kept anything in the red or black.
Where are they sending you then?
To, planetary politics. We're representing our individual planets.
Really?
It's
it's happening.
Well,
our honorable viewers, may the Force be your cover and your shield.
Let me know if there's any Pantorans there.
Of course. And I'll represent Onderon well, Mildew.
Good luck.
Oh, you make me so flattered and happy.
I know
you
both did the right thing.
To hear that.
Make sure that this thing gets started with a bang, eh?
Of course.
We'll try.
Yeah, we'll keep you.
Before you go, I foresee a vision. I feel like the Force is telling me, you will have great luck and fortune, but you will have many adversaries. In terms of, not adversaries of weapons, but adversaries of words. People who will challenge your ideas. Simply all I always said.
I appreciate your wisdom, Mildew.
Of course, and I appreciate all
as
of you.
Do I. Right, well, let me get changed.
Alright. If you have a spare, throw it my way. I'll I'll get into something a little nicer as well.
See what I have.
And then they kiss.
You two witnessed that. You two witnessed
that. Beards don't count.
Yeah, you gotta shave the beard. Okay, that looks like birds.
Well,
I don't like a beard. I'll be quite honest.
Well, I've got a brown pair of pants.
Look, I've been too scrubby.
And a white shirt.
Too long. I was just enjoying it.
Works fun.
Have at it. Hope they fit.
Thank you. Sure.
I won't get too far into it, but it is not comfortable. In fact, yes.
With, camouflage.
I tell you what, you don't really scratch it.
Right, where did I?
Not as soft as you would imagine.
I'll take this.
Had to wear all that face paint to cover ourselves.
I'll be right back. I have to go ask
him. I have not worn a beard. I don't even see how you can.
If I shave it all off, I got a baby face, and if I got a little bit of stubble, it makes me look more adult.
Nicely trimmed mustache is about as long as I'll go.
But apparently I'm going to be growing out some sideburns soon, so...
Well, that'll be something to see. I don't think I've ever seen you without that scruff on your face.
It's turning. You got your cape back on!
Yeah, well... guess it's for a good occasion. Should we...
Are you excited?
I'm very excited, actually. It's been a long time.
Well, good. I hope it's super fun and not painful.
That's an optimistic tone.
That's me.
All right, well.
Well, that's about as best as we're gonna get.
Looks snazzy enough. I'll be cocked if they make me take my holster off, though.
Ah, well. Most of the time, blasters aren't...
I'm swinging the wrong way.
Art class parties?
Well, Andron's a fighting world. Part of our culture.
Well, maybe you can argue that with the...
Ah! Attendant. God, this griffin ship!
I really have to stop following you.
I know. When it comes to these Griffin Corellian designs, you really do. I'll always get lost. Pardon me?
I'm more interested to see if you get it.
I saw the new starfighter.
Oh, we're almost there.
This goes to the armor.
What's with all the formal wear?
That's the armor.
Business! Yeah. Way, good to see you.
Oh, Criff, looking good.
Yeah, this is nice to ever see me.
You can call me Lieutenant Nav.
Of course, Honorable Lieutenant Nav. Are we showing him off too?
Alright.
Might as well get a nice look at him.
You look incredible.
Well, since I've flown, I guess it's like riding a bike, you never forget.
Yeah.
I'll break off front once you make atmosphere.
What took you so long?
Trying to suck my gut in, sir.
We're flying in
so
that
you're both,
thing?
So you're both matching. It's good look.
Put a lot of money
very
on
nice.
You even got me to comb my hair.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, maybe you should give him a bag. Those atmospherics are, going to be bouncy.
Oh, relax. This is one of our new E-Wings. We just made it from Hope Station.
Looks
but
good.
Didn't steal our last transport.
Three-seater.
Bridge. Oh, the observation.
If you sit in the top seat, Veers, it's inertial dampeners are a little bit better. You won't get as sick.
You know, Admiral, I think I've beaten it for the most part.
Really?
Yeah. It took me long enough.
Hey, well, I think we're already about to be late.
Hey, A7, you comfortable up there?
Pharaoh's gonna be flying our escort, so.
I trust you'll bring this one back, Admiral.
No problem.
You need not doubt me. I'm a good pilot.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I was.
Clear the deck, please.
Yeah.
Hop in.
What the cark is that?
Starting. Startup procedure. Sending pre-flight data to cockpit. Air traffic control, this is Nomad 1.
So I have to sit facing backwards the whole time.
Thank you, Tower. Nomad 1 acknowledges, and may the force be with you also. Starting startup procedure.
Oh, that's smooth.
All right, here we go.
Oi. All right, maybe I take it back.
Tracking gear. Break off.
It would be great if I could see it.
We got plenty of space.
Been out of this game for a long time.
Post-flight check. All systems reporting green. Confirm Nomad 1 landed and disembarking. You can get out. Ship's off.
No, we ought to, you know, we ought to ask those people at Hope Station for a ladder.
This is beautiful.
Wow.
500,000 year old ricotton architecture.
Cotton?
Oh my god.
First time seeing it myself. But it's not what we're here for.
That is the cleanest water I've ever seen.
Mostly untouched. No industrial pollution on this world.
It's gorgeous.
Watch your step. Now the cellar entrance to this castle is in a bit of a weird spot. I heard it got flooded out, but they've put a little grate down for us here.
Oh, good.
Oh.
I wasn't expecting the whole honor guard.
Yeah, that was I.
Among our many officers, he is currently on the list for commander-in-chief.
Chairman, point of personal privilege. I have just received information that the honorable delegate from Chandrilla has been held up but is on his way. He has designated me his proxy.
That is good to know.
I ask unanimous consent to enter his appearance into the record.
Match with the rest of the decor. I second. Anyone here who does not wish to enter that our honorable delegate from Chandrilla isn't here?
I heard that the delegate from Chandrilla got held up by Imperial Patrol.
Fortunately so.
Ah, we have some latecomers, I see. Oh, looks like there's two seats in the front for you two. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Honorable Speaker, thank you.
Please, take a seat.
Come on, let's
of course.
Get into the nosebleeds.
We'll quickly take attendance, and then we'll continue with our session. You gentlemen are a bit late, but we just started, so the majority of our discussion is still to be done. Alright. Delegate Longstride?
Here.
Delegate Duyos?
Present.
All right, good. Chancellor Jaffa.
Present.
Executive Officer Dalhaser.
Present.
Delegate Hakest. Delegate Haycast.
There you go. You pronounced right this time. I'm here.
Friend Sorrento?
Present.
Delegate Darus?
Present.
Steadholder Goldbane? Prince Lampar?
Present.
Viceroy Gilders?
Here.
Magister Shakar?
Present.
Delegate Jasalix?
Present.
Delegate Serene?
Present.
Representative Jolie?
Here.
President Antilles?
Here.
Emir Nebulon?
Ever present.
Envoy Harand?
Present.
Delegate Whitlet?
Present.
And of course, our Chandrilan friend has been said to be present by quorum. And I am currently present as well. Now that our Congress is in quorum, we will continue on from the previous discussion we had about our chain of commands. But before we move on to that, our first major issue is the incorporation of the former Alliance Defense Fleet remnants and other such remnant fleets into the collective Coalition Armada to be directed by the Congress and their appointed officers. We'll be having a vote on a session. You may discuss it first with your floor leaders, and then we'll have it open for a vote. Gentle beings, please discuss this among your colleagues. I'll reconvene once discussion is finished.
Very well. We'll retreat to the caucus room.
Gentlemen.
Everything must move at the pace of your...
Just go to the end of the antechamber here.
Right. There's a good place.
Does anyone have any problem with... Does anyone have any... Right.
Given her.
Is there any reason? Is there any reason why we shouldn't?
My planet is recently liberated. I strongly advocate for a strong navy.
That was never in question. A strong navy is how we're going to fight the Empire on the front lines.
Yes.
Right. The honorable member from Mondoran.
President?
Sorry. Yes, well, unfortunately, things have, gotten rather complicated since, the current party politics have fallen into factionalism. My faction, here assembled, the Unity faction, is pro a strong, central, unified republic, whereas the, opposing faction, Liberation faction, proposing something more towards a voluntary confederacy that would allow member states to join or not join by a simple majority of their constituent assembly at leisure and at will. But that's not the purpose of this vote. No, this vote will be about the Navy. Does anyone have any other considerable or other aspects we should consider related to the Republic Navy?
Logistics.
I would say
we will not be able to fund and maintain a full naval presence without civilian vessels to get food to them.
True,
so we may
but
have
they've...
to figure that out at some later date.
Well, as a the question is less
yes.
The ships. The question is less ships and more supplies themselves and how we pay for them. The ships will come as we gain more ground against the Empire.
The member from
well,
Andron
we
speaks
represent
with wisdom.
Our, we all represent our own. We represent our own planetary bodies and the resources that they provide. I'm certain that logistical issues, should they come up, will be handled, but I believe we all in agreement that a strong navy must prevail for us to win this growing conflict.
Indeed.
While I support a coalition, I think it's crucial that there is a strict oversight and accountability on our military that's focused on defense and peacekeeping, not expansion or conquest. Our goal is to protect, not to provoke.
There has to be some expansion before we can worry about just protection. The majority of our selected represented worlds here still lie underneath the oppression of the Empire. However,
agreed.
That's true.
Once
not
we
all
win
us,
this war,
not all here are as lucky as my people.
Once we win this war, we can impose a sunset clause into all military spending to vastly reduce the funding for a Star Armada. Still, we can't allow what happened before to happen again. The emergence of the Empire only happened because of our weak navy. We don't repeat the Coalition or the New Republic's lax patrol methods.
It is my belief. I apologize, President Antilles. But it is my belief that it is paramount that while we are still in active conflict with the Empire, that we maintain as strong a naval presence as we possibly can. For that is where we will defeat the Empire. We can't get boots on ground, we can't get supplies to the hungry, medicine to the sick and wounded, until we are able to defeat the Imperial Armada in space. Once the time comes where we need to lower our readiness status, that is when we can bring it to the floor. But for now, we're in a wartime state. We must do so.
Right.
I concur.
Well, we have a very, very thin majority here. Especially now that we've gotten confirmation that Chandrila will join us. However, the next vote will be very crucial. I understand from the current memorandum of order procedure, the next motion will be the Commander-in-Chief. I understand that the Liberation faction have their own candidate.
Chairman?
As one of the newest members of our quorum, along with Prince Orento,
I'd like to talk to you for a second. Explain you your the rules, regulations, and all that stuff. You gentlemen, please
just
continue your quorum and dialogue.
Yes, I think you are quite right.
Happy to see you.
Quite frankly, the other option for Commander-in-Chief.
I agree. Once this unfortunate matter is over, we can discuss later steps regarding the Navy. What were you saying about them having their own?
Yes, the
their own candidate?
Liberation faction will propose a new candidate to command the Coalition Navy. But you should not allow a change at such a sensitive stage. It's my opinion that Admiral Halsey was able to preserve the core of the Galactic Alliance's Navy through the worst. And now in victory, I do not see a need to change commanders.
To any change in command at this time.
The only thing that General Tag has is experience with a far more vast navy. That is the only thing that makes him a desired candidate. But still, I would be inclined to believe that Admiral Halsey has served the Alliance and the Triumvirate before it quite well in his capacity, and as we've seen already from the notes that we've received, his ragtag fleet of holdovers has performed exceptionally.
Indeed.
So we are agreed.
They are the sole reason why the people of Ortegas were able to send me. They liberated
exactly.
My planet. I second that, Bob.
Yes.
So we
agree.
I concur.
Halsey.
Liberation, not conquer.
Very well. So, Admiral Halsey will be Commander in Chief.
If I may, probably be pushback on it. What if, for compromise, we propose some type of tertiary title for the general if they really push hard for something?
Well, I think
that could be decided later. That could be decided later, maybe, but at the same time, we don't have time for this. We must pick one leader now. The rest we'll figure out.
It's negotiable down the line, that's all that matters.
Soon.
Here, here.
You may take your, Oh, and last thing. If you, decide on forming joining a faction, it'll probably be more effective in, doing your political goals.
I believe it will be a rich future.
Gentlemen?
Hi. Which one?
Yeah. All right.
It's just a foul.
Order. Order, please. Now that our Congress, now that we have the Congress in quorum, we will begin our vote on the incorporation of the Alliance Defense Fleet Remnant into our Federal Navy. I wish to remind our delegates. Please, first let me finish. That this is only about incorporating the current remnant defense fleets and not the creation of a new fleet. So, vote on that based on how you wish. Now, gentlemen, gentle being, please. What is your point?
I just want to speak to the Congress about the vote for a moment to reassure the feelings.
Very well. You have the floor.
As our friend Chairman has said, and he has assured us, and I trust him as working with him for many years, that this is a vote to bring in the current organized military fleets under the command of a centralized government. I know that many of us have concerns for the feeling that our personal militias and fleets should not be integrated, And as the chairman has said, that was not to be discussed, and I'm glad he's restated that for us. Thank you. And I know that you will all vote what is the best interest of not just ourselves, but the galaxy. Merci.
Thank you for your speech. Before we continue, I wish to remind that we have 2 minutes for debate for the floor leaders, and they can give out time for their own members as well. Yes. Prince Lampar, you have the floor.
Thank you.
Remember to keep it brief. We have only have 2 minutes each.
Gentle beings, I concur completely with Chancellor Jafar on this matter. It is of paramount importance that the Remnant be brought under a centralized command structure. That the Remnant, who's been fighting the Empire on the fields, on the fronts, the fleet that has been beating back oppression, be brought together as one.
Hear, hear.
Is through this coalition acting as a unified front that we will face down the Empire and find victory for each of our worlds, regardless of the path we choose in the future. What matters now is victory. That is all.
Thank you, Prince Lampar of Andron, for a passionate speech. We'll begin counting votes for the incorporation of the Alliance Defense Fleet Remnant. Please say aye for a affirmative vote, nay for a negative vote. I'll be calling from nameless. Prince Arento of Altu.
Aye.
Prince Lampar of Onderon.
Aye.
Delegate Longstrat of Artagan.
Aye.
Delegate Duyas.
Aye.
Councillor Jeffer of the Twi'lek government.
Aye.
EXO Delheezer.
Aye.
Delegate Haycass.
Aye.
Delegate DeRoos.
Aye.
Dead Order Goldbane of Bakun. Viceroy Girdles of the Outer Rim Company.
Aye.
Master Shakar.
Aye.
Delegate Jasalix.
Aye.
Delegate Serene.
Aye.
Representative Jalee.
Aye.
Resident Antilles.
On behalf of Alderaan and Chandrila, aye.
Emir Nebulon.
Aye.
Envoy Harand. Envoy Arend?
Aye.
Delegate Whitlight?
Aye.
I also vote aye. The motion passes unanimously.
Yeah.
Hear, hear.
Hear, hear.
A stronger galaxy. Thank the Force.
Gentlemen, we'll be moving on to the second issue that is on our list. Now that we have federalized the remnants of the Alliance Defense Fleet, the question is who shall lead it? If you may remember from our previous session of the Military Subcommittee, we have two names that have been brought forward. I'll quickly introduce those two gentlemen, and then we'll have a time for some debate and discussion between the floor leaders, and then we shall vote. The first candidate, the first officer is General Tag. He is a triumvirate general of major experiences. He's opposed the illegal coup by the cabal of colonels on the triumvirate. Yeah. He opposed the tyrant Fennec and his illegal government. He rebuked the Sith Order. He did not continue service in a corrupt institution such as the New Imperium. He supported the Alliance for the last 2 decades with his own money, as well as his own family's money, as well as troops. And remember, he's a man of many experiences and many medals under his chest. General Tag. Our second contender is Admiral Halsey. He started off as a naval aviator in the Triumvirate Fleet. Then he was also trained in the Galactic Alliance Defense Fleet. He fought in the Neo-Mandalorian War. He rose to the rank of Admiral in the Triumvirate. He has commanded the Alliance Fleet for the last 2 decades, fighting against the Imperium with the Resistance. And most recently, he has seized the Entrala Kuat shipyards and turned them into our own tools. We now have discussions for floor leaders to talk with their constituencies. Gentle beings, you're free to discuss.
Thank you.
Right. Point of personal privilege.
Yes.
I move for a recess to caucus with my faction.
Any seconded?
Seconded.
It's a personal privilege motion, doesn't need to be seconded. Let's go.
Well.
Okay.
I have some passionate words to share on behalf of Admiral Halsey.
Okay, so the member from Onderon wants, how long do you think that'll take you?
Not very long.
2 minutes?
Maybe.
All right.
Just about.
Okay. All right, and then does anyone else want to speak?
Are we in agreement that Admiral Halsey is the best choice? Because I fervently believe it is.
Given the fact that he saved my planet from the Empire's boot heel.
Agreed.
100% agree.
Good.
Yes,
I see no reason to have a military general in charge.
Very well. I will give 2 minutes to Lampar, 30 seconds to Longstride, 30 seconds to Stadtholder, Coldbrain. Give me a second, I'm gonna go talk to the faction leader.
Admiral Halsey, I can speak from personal experience. He is what we need, more so than anything else. He's, as I said, this war will be won in the space rather than the ground. I don't believe I trust a general to run our navies alongside our ground forces. Admiral Halsey has proven to be effective at both.
It's not us you need to convince.
Ugh, I'm more getting my thoughts out there.
There.
Just
well then, go ahead.
Prepared to compromise. It's always keep it in the... Give something.
I believe General Taig has a place, of course. But now's our commander-in-chief, he's not what we need.
I agree.
We will, however, probably need someone to assist with a second fleet. We have enough ships. So, with respect to the man's war record, because he has a very impressive war record, I would say...
They both do.
I would say in the future, if we have a second fleet, we give it to General Tag. But
that'll be up to Admiral Halsey as the commander in chief.
Second fleet. We should worry about a second fleet later. First, we need to get through this session. Exactly.
It'll be to the commander in chief's word anyhow on who gets what in what fleets. Once they manifest, that will be the commander in chief's prerogative. And I believe Admiral Halsey will choose well.
Prince Lanpar, how would you describe Admiral Halsey's character?
Inscrutable.
We have 5 minutes, so I'll give 2 to the honorable member from Onderon, and then 2 to Longstride, or sorry, 30 seconds to Longstride, and then Stadtholder Goldvein. Do you want 30 seconds? 45? What are you thinking? Okay.
I could speak to it.
Alright, 30 seconds to Mr. White Light.
Whitlight.
Whitlight? Sorry. Alright, let's resume our seats.
I believe we are poor in our beliefs.
I cannot speak for the others, but that myself is ready to support it.
I also think from a more practical perspective that General Tag also knows his colleagues as well quite well, and would help potentially to understand their tactics and what they do, even bring some of them to our side, if we're going to be practical here.
And as I will say in the debate, Admiral Halsey has been in command of the Alliance.
We have main component. Last few seconds, let's try to wrap it up quickly.
Do you think they have a good stance here?
I will sit on the floor.
Right.
No, you'll make the right decision.
Yeah.
I see that we are currently quorum. We now have the 2 minute allotted for each party leader to make their case on our debate floor. Does the party leaders wish to make their cases?
Yes.
President Antilles, you have the floor.
Fellow members, only one candidate has a proven track record of successfully maintaining their command through extreme adversity. We are only here because of the actions and the accomplishments of one man. And that is Admiral Halsey. He, and only he, commanded his flotilla through the darkest of the Imperial occupation, preserved it so that it may strike again, and he, and only he, has provided us the tools with which to build an armada to oppose tyranny, not just here, but in the Outer Rim, and in the Mid Rim, and in the Core. He, and only he, has the vote of the delegation of Alderaan, Chandrila, and the entirety of the Uni faction. I now cede to my honorable member in the Liberation faction and reserve the remainder of my time.
Thank you. Thank you. Gentle beings, friends. We are not here to question the military achievements of Admiral Halsey. But it is certainly incorrect to say that he is the only one who has affected the battle of which we have been waging. Myself and my colleagues have fears. Fears that one day the war will require more troops than is capable to be wielded by the Admiral. We know and are confident in the fact that General Tag has shown time and time again his ability to command an army and fleet without the requirement of reinforcements and still to achieve victory. Unlike Admiral Halsey's fleet, which is continually requesting supplies from what I understand.
Quite so.
We must look to the future of what is to be built from these meetings and to the security of our planet and the galaxy. It is imperative that the centralized army as a commander who can fight the battles with the resources that he is able to command and not be left to believe that he can take whatever he wants and still have the confidence of the people. General Tang is the competent commander. He is a better logistician and he is simply the best choice command a unified military foot coalition. I yield the rest of my
time.
Here,
here.
This is the truth.
Agreed.
We're here.
Thank you all for your speech.
Fuck wisdom.
We'll be going down the list. Make sure you say the name of the commander in chief you want to lead our combined armies. Prince Sorrento.
I'm sorry, can you repeat?
Yes, please say the name of the commander you wish to represent our new combined fleets.
While I respect the opinions of our liberationist friends, I will be going with Admiral Halsey.
Prince Lampar?
I support Admiral Halsey.
Delegate Longstride?
Given my planet suffered under the boot heel of the Empire until Admiral Halsey arrived, I support Admiral Halsey.
Delegate Duryas?
Support General Tag.
Chancellor Jeffer?
On behalf of the Twi'lek government, I know I can confidently say that we support General Tag.
EXO Dalheiser?
The Mining Guild will support General Tag.
Delegate Haycast.
Free Rock supports Halsey.
Delegate Darus.
The planet of Baron Fa will support General Tag.
Stadtholder Goldbane. Viceroy Gelders.
We stand in favor of General Tag.
Magister Shakar.
Malastar supports General Tag.
Delegate Jasalix.
Hosnian Prime continues to support Admiral Halsey.
Delegate Serene.
On behalf of the Bothan people, we stand in solidarity, Mr. Halsey.
Delegate Jolene.
On behalf of the Irishi sector, we vote for Admiral Sol Halsey.
President Antilles.
On behalf of Shadrilla and Alderaan, we vote Halsey.
Emir Nebulon.
The planet of Arbaflex and our shipyard stand behind the man amongst men, General Tag.
Envoy Harend.
Arcanus supports General Tag.
Delegate Whitlight.
The bravery of this man's fleet goes unspoken. Plethora stands with Admiral Halsey.
Sit. Planet of Pentora, we're not cast a vote in this selection. We'll now begin counting our votes. Admiral Halsey, you have been selected
well
by the Congress to lead as Commander-in-Chief of our fleets.
This will be
until we dismiss you from your post.
What is the meaning of
you have won by two votes.
Here, here.
Clearly
here. For a free Onderon.
For the future of our cooperation.
My, colleague General Tag is an esteemed commander, and I know that he will continue to, serve this coalition in whatever capacity this Congress sees fit. I am truly sensible of the high honor done me in this appointment, yet I feel a great distress, consciousness that my abilities and experience may not be equal to this extensive and important trust. However, as the Congress desires it, I will enter upon this monumentous duty, exert every power I possess in their service and for the support of this glorious cause. Thank you.
Force be with you, Halsey.
Moving speech, Admiral Halsey. Thank you for your time, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Gentle beings, before our newest members of our quorum arrived, we had just discussed the makeup of our galactic system of governance. And before we couldn't reach a quorum of the issue, but we did manage to narrow it down. If we wish to have a unitary galactic system, or more confederal galactic system. This is a very important question that we must answer to determine the future of our nations. We have 5 minutes to discuss amongst yourselves and your floor mates on how we shall steer the ship forward. Actually, this is such an important issue. We're going to have a short recess. We need to discuss this issue in all its depths. Gentlemen, may you make your decisions with solemnity it requires and the weight of honor. We will choose for the future.
Yeah, let's go back to the cox room.
Well, so pleased that Halsey got that.
Okay.
I believe we made quite a good decision.
Same.
Alright. Here's what we're going to do. First of all, how do we feel about the motion?
Quite frankly, forgive me, I don't mean to talk over you.
Go ahead.
If I may, we must stand together, united, as our name suggests, in this conflict to break into a confederation where everyone has to agree is quite simply impossible to win a war with. We must stand together and pool our resources.
Right. I speak on behalf of Onderon, a world that, without the extensive support of the Republic over these centuries, would have never seen the prosperity that it had. Be it not under the systems in which we found solidarity in the past.
Hold on. Keep talking. I just need to talk to Joe Wax.
Had we not found this strength in solidarity with the Republic of old, the Galactic Republic, the Second Galactic Republic,
okay,
the New Republic,
your job is to
the planet of Onderon would not have prospered as it had. As such, in the interests of my world, I must support a unified Galactic Republic.
Here for that. Yes. Does anyone have any points?
I need to go talk to the chairman real quick. Let me circle back here. All right. I've just made Jolax. I'm saying your name wrong. I'm sorry. I've just made him whip. All right. So he's going to make sure that we have one platform. And we're going to vote it. All right. Now I'm going to go talk to the chairman to make sure everyone gets a chance to speak. All right.
Bye.
I'd find you here.
Yeah. Everyone, the delegate from Chandrilla is here. Delegate, you can introduce yourself. I'm gonna go talk to the chairman.
Good evening.
Name's Castlereagh. Pleasure to be here.
We heard you were held up by an Imperial patrol. Are you quite alright?
Yes, that's right. We're all fine, though. We were able to outrun them, we spat chaff at them.
Good man.
That is excellent to hear.
Error.
Prince Lampar of Onderon. Pleasure to meet you, Delegate.
Sir.
We were discussing...
Join us. Oh, go ahead,
after
Mr. Whitlight.
After you, I insist.
We were discussing the current state of how the Coalition will function after the war has passed, if we will maintain a unitary system or a confederate system.
must have a strong central government, and that much is very abundantly clear.
I 100% agree with that. I do not wish my world to ever face another invader unaided again.
It is clear. Exactly. Divided, we shall fall one by one to whatever warlords or monsters take the place of this empire when it is defeated. We must be ready to stand together.
And this goes past just defending ourselves. This helps the people on the fringes. If every planet gets to make whatever price they want for all their agricultural needs, and the people on the fringes suffer because they can't compete with those prices.
The galactic economy will suffer, and the worlds on the rim will suffer.
Well, and we can also secure the prosperity of all life as a unitary government, instead of letting each planet decide for themselves.
Indeed. A strong, enforceable constitution for our new alliance will make sure that the rights of all sentients are respected, and that all worlds are seen equal under the eyes of our new republic.
Hear, hear!
Absolutely.
That will be a rather bold one to try to push through.
Well, these are bold times, aren't they?
Aye, but not even the last republic was capable of banning slavery. Well, I'm no fan of slavery myself, but I'm not sure we'll be able to pass it.
I just talked to the,
President?
Right. No, no, continue. Alright, I just spoke with the, Chancellor, and, we're gonna do unlimited time for side, but no more than 2 minutes per person. So, who wants to speak, and who doesn't, on the issue?
I shall.
Alright, so, Lampar, Light.
I would.
Alright.
I am happy to speak on the subject.
Alright. Keep track of who's speaking in which order. And then when it's your turn, if you want recognition, so what we're going to do, okay, it's going to be traded off. They're going to go first, then one of our speakers will go, then one of their speakers will go, then one of our speakers will go, right? No more than 2 minutes per speaker. And then if you want to speak, when it's our turn, stand, and I'll yield time to you, all right?
Understood.
Very well.
Of course. All right. You have 2 minutes, but you don't have to use the whole 2 minutes.
Don't win, Jim. Don't.
All you have to say is very short and sweet. Don't worry.
Thou shalt try to keep it short. No promises.
That slavery issue will be hard with Chancellor Jeffra, huh?
Let us bring forth the issue of slavery on a tertiary vote. For the time being, let's remain focused on this current issue. Let's make our points clear and concise.
Excellent idea. If we divide the topic too much, they won't agree with us at all. So, as such, do we have a concise idea as to...
Well, quite simply put, a house divided cannot stand.
I will speak on the...
That's what we all agree on.
I will speak on the need of continued stability past the destruction of the Empire, as well as the ideals of a constitution to ensure the rights of sentience going forward, that we, as a centralized government, can enforce. Of course.
Prince Lampar, your other princely friend, he's not with us presently, is he?
He is not.
Did he... join the,
I've not had the moment to speak to him on the matter.
I see.
Hmm. Well, if we've got someone crossed in the aisle, you should speak to him while we have the time.
I'll see if I can pull him away for a second. John Binks.
What do you mean?
Right, go on.
I'll let you speak. A moment.
Yes. Well, to what extent? Do you want to declare slavery legal?
Excuse me, Mr. President.
I think that there could be some latitude among member worlds for local affairs.
Perhaps if there's some oversight, however, for the main government.
Well, the larger issue is whether or not the central government should be bounded or not. Ultimately, if we
there
allow
should be time,
sectionalism,
time limits on terms,
time
without doubt.
We can discuss the specifics once the actual vote is passed. However, right now we need to settle on an actual system of governance. The rules that come with
agreed.
That system are to be established at a later time. We
and
must
I agree,
first
however,
win this conflict.
Someone across the aisle may put that question to you. How can you guarantee
we
someone will not turn out to be a dictator like an emperor?
We are
it's
for a
good
republic.
Idea, excuse me, delegate, to inform them not of the fact that there's a constitution yet to be written, but that the basis of a strong central government has ideals that are stronger than a confederacy. Uniform standards, the protection of rights, streamlined administration, redistribution of resources, all of those cannot be possible under confederacy. And that is what we have to address. Not the fact that we don't have term limits assigned, not the fact that we don't understand exactly how the election will go. But I think it's important that they understand the importance of what we're trying to achieve here, which is overall well-being of the entire galaxy.
The fundamental issue with Confederacy is that it will be large planets ruling over the small. With an accountable central government, small planets like ours, like yours, will be represented. They will hold the larger planets accountable. We'll have strong individual rights. However, we can't let what has happened for eons continue, where the core exploits the outer rim. Ultimately, the one innovation the Empire brought is that they didn't allow the corporations to run roughshod over the citizen or the Outer Rim. If we are going to protect our system, we must allow a strong government to rule with democratic virtue instead of blind thievery or tyranny. Now, if there's any particular question about our philosophy, I'll field it. Don't need to worry about that much. The larger issue, however, is going to be Altamine and Andron. They could be the ultimate decider of this issue. Understand, now that Chandrila is here, we finally have some big guns, so to speak.
Chandrila's here.
What do you think? What do you think?
I think that the Liberation Caucus is already seated and waiting for us.
Aye, they are.
Still Strider's, well, he'll return.
I've, spoken to my colleague. I believe,
What does he say?
I believe he'll vote for it, or with us.
Very good.
Excellent news.
One less headache to worry about.
Circle in order of, to the next person. Then it will be...
Remember,
this table,
if you
want to
be recognized,
one,
just
other,
stand.
Next, wait for the other. Then it will be you, my friend, wait for the other. Same, okay? Question?
I'll speak on the issue last.
Very well.
Who's going
understood?
To speak on behalf of Plethia since he stepped away?
I hope he'll return, but if it comes to it, we'll exercise his proxy.
I'll do it if I must.
Thank
very
you,
well.
Sir.
Gentle beings, welcome back. We are missing a member. Does your caucus wish to...
The honorable member from Plethia had to step out to consult with his government, but has extended proxy to Chandrila.
Understood. I've been made aware that the floor leaders have devised the way they wish to discuss this issue. Is
that correct?
Correct.
Very well. Since you've all done your homework and how to speak, gentlemen, will you raise the issue of our galactic system of governance, whether we have a unitary or a confederal style of government? You have the floor.
Honorable gentle beings, colleagues and friends. It is not an easy choice when talking about the politics of the entirety of the galaxy and the future in which we will create. But as many of my friends have said to me and will say to you, it is important that the tyranny of the Empire we seek to destroy will never return. And the only way in order to do that is to preserve the personal economies and militaries of the individual systems so that they have the right to self-preservation and self-protection. The future of the galaxy is not a united republic, but a coalition of free planets aligned with the best interests of the galaxy at heart. We must ensure that the Empire,
or the
wherever
best interest of themselves.
Its next seed is planted, is stamped out before it is even allowed to burst through the ground. If the enemy place their feet down on my planet, then my army and my economy will destroy them before they can wreak havoc on the entirety of the galaxy.
Quite so.
We must not allow the confusion that is liberty versus oppression. We must think of it like this. The liberty of the free planet to make the decisions to save the galaxy, or the oppression of the state to control the action of the individual.
Right.
The methodology will be simple. Floor leaders will delegate time to various constituent members. I reserve my time to speak last. I now recognize the honorable member from Andron for 2 minutes.
Gentle beings, I would like to tell you about the world of Andron. Andron is a small world of which, without a system of unified governments across the galaxy, we would not be able to feed our people as effectively. We would not be able to protect ourselves as effectively. Our world relies on these kinds of supports. Now consider, Andoron is one world of thousands, a core world at that, ones that have always been seen under the lights of various governments as important, quote-unquote, whether you believe such or not. Think of the worlds of the Rim, of the Mid-Rim, the Outer Rim. They will suffer the greatest if left to the devices of their own. They need proclamations. They need the proclamations of a secure constitution that will guarantee their rights as sentients, that will guarantee them food on their plates, credits in their pockets. It is our duties not to look at just our own worlds, but of the greater galaxy. When I walked the war-torn worlds across this galaxy and I saw what the Empire did to them, I resolved myself that I would never let such oppression be wrought again. And it is under our unified system that we will ensure that no government, extragalactic or otherwise, will trample the rights of the individual sentience. I yield my time.
If I may, your insinuation that the Mid and Outer Rims are incapable of taming themselves and rendering themselves because of extragalactic empires is ridiculous. if and when we were brought to our knees, it was only because the whole world surrendered their likeness and their goods to a greater evil to embark their oppression upon the smaller systems and trading financiers, crushing us under their heels so we can no longer breathe,
nothing but
firing
truth.
Up the emulators of their so-called unification to burn away our individual liberties. Mind you, the core worlds are the source of much oppression. How many times has a core world decided to deny trade to its lesser brothers, starving them? How many times has a core world done so to hurt the miners?
Maybe under the Empire!
You assume that we are weaker. We are strong in and of our own rights. You simply do not see it. You see us as a destroyed little child. You will never see us as much. You think of us as a charity case.
Uncalled for.
We are more so than that. We are strong and powerful beings of this galactic world.
The Republic has done the same.
The only thing ridiculous about the outer mid-rim is the central idea that we are not capable of tending to ourselves. A centralized government will only lead to a centralized welfare state that will only destroy the Outer Rim and her sisters and brothers. I yield the remainder of my
This is completely bogus and out of line.
Nothing
stops
the Republic from turning into
a living farce.
Not true.
Exactly.
Untrue.
Excellent.
Very well. Rousing speech. I yield 2 minutes to the honorable member standing.
Ladies and gentlemen of the Congress before me, we are here thinking of greater picture items such as how this will economically impact our planets.
Shut!
Yeah, exactly.
Let the man speak!
Let's focus on what we think.
You think it's the truth. Of only the impacts to your economies, you think not of your people. Your people matter more. There are more important things than money in this galaxy. The lives of those around us are what matter.
Who talks of money?
With a strong centralized government, with a strong centralized government, we can guarantee rights for every sentient being in this galaxy, regardless of species.
Hear, hear!
The right of self-determination!
With this guaranteed rights, we can ensure that such antiquated ideas fall out of favor so that everyone is given a fair shot in this galaxy. To ensure that no one
antiquated.
Goes hungry at night.
Hear,
hear!
Potential corporations do not exploit their workers for pennies.
Exactly!
A centralized government would exploit their own workers.
With this, a centralized government, we can provide security for those people, for our planets that we have. Tethria is a small world with a small army. A strong centralized government allows that security for my people.
It will only lead to a downfall like the Republics of old.
The Republics of old were able to defend their people. I yield my time to the speaker.
I'm
well done!
Hear, hear.
Yeah.
Seems our friends have been misled.
Bit unfortunate.
Liberation Caucus, your next speaker.
It's your turn.
Tell them the truth.
The other side is horrifically, horrifically inaccurate with their claims and such. The Bothan people greatly of loss, suffering of each of these conflicts that we have unfortunately had to have encounter and deal with.
They're a fine people.
We feel that we deserve the right.
Can you hear him?
To funded government.
Calm
we
down.
Believe that we deserve the absolute right to have a personal militia in case of the Galactic Alliance going down, collapsing. It is needed to ensure that
soft-spoken man with soft-spoken ideals.
Show some respect.
What's that? The sound of the central rim drowning us out again?
Often people desire our own government. Centralization will only lead to collapse and further decay and poverty, thus more suffering to everyone involved. We cannot go down this path. That is all. I give my time to the other side.
Yeah. Now.
So it
you
is.
Did
well,
well
said, friend.
I can't hear him.
Most spoken delegate.
The Unity faction recognizes the honorable delegate from Hosnian Prime for 2 minutes.
Gentle beings, I recognize your concern in a loss of autonomy and individual freedom. However, I ask you to recognize the importance of an overall central government and central militia when it comes to preserving rights across the galaxy. Universal standards, such as centralized laws, ensure that everyone, regardless of where they live, be it core worlds or outer rim, have the same rights and protections. It prevents regional disparities and guarantees individual freedoms are upheld and uniformly. I would also like to add that it encourages innovation by setting broad goals and standards for the entirety.
There is no
the central government can encourage local governments to innovate. Empowering local governments is also a part of a strong central government. A strong central government can still support and empower local governments by providing funding, setting standards, and ensuring accountability across all worlds. This allows local authorities to address specific community needs while maintaining cohesion.
We do not
I think it's also important to recognize crisis. There is crisis, my friends, in this galaxy.
Yeah,
and a strong
central
government
will
coordinate responses to national and international emergencies, natural disasters, illness, sickness, unprecedented disasters and crime and evilness, protecting individuals and ensuring that everyone receives help regardless
evilness.
Of where they live.
Evil.
I give up the rest of my time.
Who is to stop the core from here?
Well said, well said. Yeah.
Well said.
Yes, I'm sure our friend will do a great job leading our nation into glory when they enact another Emergency Powers Act for the greater good of the core.
Imagine some bankers blockading another planet.
I will speak on this if. If there is someone elected under this new central government, right, then what happens if they end up being corrupt? Like
exactly.
The current emperor of the empire, Emperor Fang, right?
This is
they
ridiculous.
Will enact the same actions that they are doing on us.
Who is to stop? Who is to check the power of the central authority?
Who
and
is
then,
to stop
this
the
is a question
Congress.
Of the Constitution that
we decide. This is not a constitutional.
They will impose
Where
more
are
oppression
you interrupting him?
On our
Let
people.
Him finish speaking.
On our people by enforcing taxes, enforcing harsh regulations, and with a central government, with you people voting for a central government, you are no better than the imperials.
You people.
As if we are not all a member of the Federation.
Hey.
To say that we are the one that called you scum, yet you call us you people.
You hear that? Federation.
Delegate, please. Jocelyn, sit. Sit.
Gentle beings. Please. Let's try to be a bit more civil. I know this. Everyone is very passionate about their ideals. They bring it down a notch. Thank you. Your faction has the floor.
Very well. Who seeks recognition? Very well, I delegate 2 minutes to the standing member.
Thank you, sir. Honorable gentle beings, Artagus has always been weak militarily. Were it not for the aid of others, I would not be stood here today with all of you. Simply put, a house divided will never stand. Similarly, if we fail to stand together, how long will it take before a new emperor seeks to exploit our division? Seeks to spread hate, fear amongst us? If we are united, we can have representation. That is all I have to say. Thank you. I yield the rest of my time.
Well, well said, delegate.
Very well spoken.
Who talks of division, huh?
I believe the men on your side that called us you people.
Hey.
Would you shut your mouth? Your time is over.
We preach safety, liberty to our people.
Right. Honorable gentle beings, hearken your ears to my woes. I stand before you with a single question. Why should the sons of Arbiflex be torn from their homes, sent to perish on distant shores under this banner of a unified army? Are we to relinquish our autonomy, our identity, to become mere pawns to leave our homes in peril? No, nay, I say, our strength lies in our diversity, in the autonomy of our planets and regions, each defending its own with zeal and courage. A unified legion means centralized control, stripping us of our ability to protect our own interests, to defend our unique way of life. Let us not sacrifice our lamb of sovereignty on the altar of false unity. A planet without her autonomy is like a cruiser with its ships with its shield down and its weaponry unarmed. Reflect on what I have said. Reflect and think.
This is the truth.
Beautifully stated, my friend.
I believe they are.
You're truly worthy of your position.
They are untrustworthy of other worlds.
Thank you, my friend. You are too.
Who seeks recognition in the Coalition of Unity? Chandrilla?
No comments at the moment.
Try to make us think we are some kind of criminal.
We reserve our time and yield to the Coalition for Liberation.
Fellow gentle beings, I represent the system of Arda for Mining World. We don't have many rich or luxurious world or planet. I mean, cities. We're simply a peaceable people, the most truly peaceable people of the Gordian Reach. Our military is nothing to speak of, and I believe that anybody here would say we're quite laughable. At least that's what everybody would say. But I believe that our contribution, though material, is quite, pardon me, I'm lost.
He's
in my
not
thoughts.
Very good at this.
Well, there he goes.
What I'm trying to say is that the military of Arda, though small, cannot, in no good faith, send her meager forces out off to foreign wars in defense of planets that would never, ever give support to Arda in her time of need.
Here, here.
And how can that be?
I'll take it to help anyone in need without a second's hesitation.
And on unitary government, how can force conscription, such a law, under the Empire, be given to Arda, a population so small and insignificant in comparison to the bigger, most economically sound core worlds? It's simply irrational.
They're trying to force their laws on us.
I yield the remainder of my time.
Mr. Speaker, I'd like to speak. Wishes to speak. Please, 2 minutes.
I'd like the permission to roam as well.
Very well. Just don't get too close and invade the privacy of other delegates.
Of course. Now, the people on the Liberationists, they have great truth among them, something that gave me a lot of pause. But I'd like everybody here to think about something. A small planet in the middle of nowhere. Bakun. Planet that sits before you here in this very assembly.
Here, here.
Bakun was a small planet with technology thousands of years out of date. They decided that the Empire was no longer something they wanted to live in.
You can blame them for that.
They were unable to do it alone. Their planet was not able to fight the resources of the Empire, and it was only with the intervention of the Alliance that Bakun was able to be free and sit before you here today. Mm. This planet has an emboldened people, not very dissimilar from any of ours. They are a planet of fighters, people who want nothing more than to yearn free. But unfortunately, without a unitary system, these planets would not be able to walk free from the Empire. And we cannot allow freedom to be a commodity for the rich.
Hear, hear.
Hear, hear.
What about
well said.
The Republic, huh?
True.
Yeah, exactly.
Seeing as the honorable member from Altamine spoke on our behalf, we yield our time to the Coalition for Liberation.
I shall keep this short, as I was never very much of a public speaker. I would like to bring to your memory two separate centralized governments. Very recent, in fact. The first, that of the Old Republic, turned into the Empire. 1,000 years of decadence quickly swept away by one single man taking power at the helm of this insurmountable pyramid, converting it into this twisted machine with which to execute his most malicious machinations. And now the second example of the Galactic Triumvirate. Yes, perhaps a centralized government might be the option in the short term, but you must think further ahead. The Republic lasted 1,000 years, but despite its longevity, its centralization was its cause of downfall.
This is the truth.
Perhaps we must explore other options. Perhaps a change. I defer my time.
Yeah.
Excellently spoken, friend.
Well said. Well said.
Very well. The Coalition for Unity recognizes the honorable member from Chandrilla.
My colleagues and esteemed members of this Congress assembled here, I must say to you, when this cruel war is over, what is it that we will have? Shall we have
freedom,
a new republic, or a confederacy of independent systems?
Hear, hear!
Republic.
I recognize the diversity of our great galaxy. It does us much service, it does. But a lack of unity, as would be experienced under Confederation, will allow tyranny to erase that diversity. Just as the Triumvirate, a confederation of three great powers, allowed the Sith to rise and conduct genocide against the minorities of this galaxy. The Plantorans, the Doros, the Rhodians, they're all dead by the millions because of the inaction and the inequity of these centralized systems.
You're blind to the
Our
true
republic
facts of that
must be a republic for all the galaxy. We can achieve effective government for all planets by coming together, not by pushing each other apart.
Well said!
Well spoken.
As has happened in history before, after recovering our liberties so coveted, we fall to internal strife and squabble. We will inevitably again stand to lose those liberties.
Hear, hear!
I have looked. I have looked for my liberties in the manifesto of the Liberation Faction, and I have not found them. I find in the ideals of the Unity Faction those liberties. I yield my time.
Well said!
Well spoken, well spoken, sir.
Make your own decisions.
Which faction? Has everyone spoken that has wished to speak?
It will be now the last member of our side, the envoy Erlen.
Thank you, honorable delegates, for your time and for.
Hear, hear!
You do not have an answer!
Exactly, yes. It'll be different.
Don't true.
The
don't
how will this republic be any different from the last?
Chairman.
This is a different time, envoy!
And we must learn from our mistakes of the past, or else we are doomed to repeat them.
It is not a mistake if it is a different time!
Gentlemen,
so nice.
Additionally, I ask the following question.
Yes. If the honorable member addresses questions, could the honorable member please address questions to a particular member of this constituency?
This man is no politician, he's a bureaucrat.
Now, as I was saying, I also pose the following question. Now, as many of you were reporting to the entire delegation, as many of you were saying before, you're from small planets with meager production and output, and I respect that for one. And your contribution to our cause is not something to be forgotten. However, I can speak on behalf of the constituency of Arcanus that why are we responsible for holding up their government and holding up their way of life? Why should we be responsible for this?
This is
not our responsibility. Our responsibility now is to fight for the liberation of the people of this galaxy. And then what comes next? Confiscation of our property at the government's, at our expense by the government. First you start with our ships, and then
there
our slaves, and then
nonsense.
Our food. What next?
This
how do we stop this? The only way to court is the preservation of our rights in a confederation of independent systems.
This is preposterous.
I
you
yield
are
my time.
Afraid of other systems.
You would leave us weak.
Well you
spoken.
Only trust yourself.
You would leave us weak.
This man speaks nothing but the truth. You know nothing, young man.
You have no understanding of what other systems would do for other systems.
You, it is
a confederacy is inherently selfish. There is nothing inherently good.
Hogwash!
I will sit with these people.
Honorable gentlemen, you will sit down.
Autocrats.
The leader is no more than a bureaucrat in uniform.
Seek the recognition of the chair.
It is not a matter of intelligence, but a matter of trust in your fellow society.
We are too stupid to govern our own worlds, is that it?
May your days be glorious.
No! In fact, it's the opposite. We trust you to help ours.
Exactly. We trust you to do what's best for you, and we'll trust ourselves.
The man wishes to speak!
We can exchange goods and assist each other as we see fit, but you're not holding
me at
last point and force me to give you goods.
Discussion time has been over, gentlemen.
Chairman.
Gentle beings, our discussion time has been allocated and completely used now. Please.
I wish to give my closing remarks.
If we're
last
at a point of orders, then we will be going to vote.
President,
Chairman.
Yes, spoken, Mr. Chairman, please.
Yes.
Gentle beings, I represent the Honorable Alderaan. Not just New Alderaan, but Alderaanians everywhere. But today, I stand before you not solely as a representative of Alderaan, but as a voice for unity, justice, and progress. Virtues here. That Alderaan here, has here. Always stood for.
Here,
our
here.
Galaxy here. Has been torn apart by conflict after conflict, division after division, and the general pursuit of power. It is time for us to rise above our differences and forge a new, more connected path. A path guided by the principles of a central, accountable, and democratic government.
Here, to forge a better future together.
Is essential for stability and prosperity. A system where individual planets, systems retain their autonomy while contributing to a unified whole. Not one of tyranny, but one of cooperation. A delicate balance that would ensure liberty and security. We find ourselves at a crossroads. The glorious Republic has fallen.
He is mad.
Yet, a tyrannous empire stands, threatening peace and freedom, not just on my world, but on many of yours as well.
He's very good at stating the facts.
The Outer Rim struggles with lawlessness. The core worlds grapple with endless bureaucracy, unaccountable to anyone. It is time for us to heed wisdom.
Here.
To create a government that serves all, regardless of origin or species.
Yes, exactly.
It will require a strong executive, a robust senate, a central economic vision, and unity in diversity. All backed up by a strong standing military that will not allow the disaster that has befallen the coalition to repeat itself. My fellow delegates, we cannot afford to remain fragmented. The time has come to transcend planetary boundaries and embrace common purpose. Let us build a unified government, one that honors our past, secures our present, and paves a way to a glorious future.
He speaks may the Force guide us
to forge a more perfect galaxy.
He's only given empty platitudes.
I urge you to vote yes to the measure. Thank you for your time.
What? Yes
to another Palpatine.
For a unified republic.
For a unified republic.
Mr. Speaker,
yes,
I motion for a call.
We're
going to
kill each other before we even defeat
the
Empire.
Seconded!
Alright, I hear a second. We'll now move on the vote on a measure.
Here, here.
Our system of galactic governance. We'll vote as similar to how we chose our commander-in-chief. You say if you wish a unitary government or a confederal government. Prince Arento of Altu.
Unitary.
Prince Lampar of Onderon.
Unitary.
Yes.
Delegate Longstrad of Artagan.
As always, unity.
Delegate Duyo Savarda.
Confederal.
Chancellor Jeffer, the Twi'lek government.
For the Confederacy.
Executive Officer Dalheiser of the Mining Guild.
The Mining Guild supports a confederal form of government.
Delegate Haycass.
Free Rock and his people vote for unity.
Delegate Darus of Baran Fa.
A confederacy.
Stadtholder Goldbane of Bakun. Viceroy Gilders of the Honorable Outer Rim Company.
Confederation now and confederation forever.
Here.
Delegate Jasalix of Hosnian Prime.
Hosnian Prime supports unitization.
Delegate Serene of the Botan Sector.
On behalf of the people of Bothawu, we stand with the Confederacy.
Representative Jolly of the Irishi Sector.
The Irishi Sector stands firm in a unified government.
Yeah, yeah.
President Antilles of Alderaan.
Alderaan and her people are for unity.
Hear, hear.
Emir Nebulon, the Arbiflex.
The choice is obvious even to the blind. The Emirate of Arbiflex stands with the Confederacy.
Hear, hear.
Envoy Haran of the Regency Systems.
The Regency System stands for Confederation.
Duggan Whitlate of Pletia.
We stand with unity.
Duggan Kesseray of Chandrilla.
The planetary government of the Car World of Chandrilla, for whom the people and governor of that planet I represent, votes in favor of a strong and unitary republic.
Here, here, here.
Here, here.
Yes, yes, Car World.
The planet Pantora votes with unity.
Here, here.
Come on.
Very well. We'll be counting our votes now. With 8 votes. With 8 votes given to a confederal system of governance. And with 10 votes given to a unified system of governance. The unity faction wins the vote.
No!
Yeah,
this is disastrous.
When the government falls in 100 years, you have yourselves to blame.
Well, our last point of order is the issue of slavery across the galaxy.
No, it must be abolished!
No.
Sense.
We can't talk about that.
Second.
We're not dismissing this, it will be talked about today!
Well, we'll be dismissing this issue for future Congress.
This what?
You're
missing
millions.
You will not tell us how to live.
This is outrageous!
How can you? How
can
you?
Outrageous!
Hey!
You've done enough
made
destruction
great
of our
galactic
liberty
for one day.
Not even 10 minutes into this new
form
of republic and all
the
intelligence
to you, the
for
the
future. The section has been ended.
Forgotten.
It'll be tabled for the future.
You slaves!
You can't stop. You can't wait to destroy
all table it. Liberties. Table the discussion of slavery for now.
I should bring
what?
The mace for you.
For now. We'll meet again.
Ridiculous.
What else is ridiculous?
Thank you all for your, thank
what
you for your
joke.
Time, gentlemen.
Alright, let's go to the conference room. Well, conference area, I guess.
Boneheaded.
I'll meet you in a moment. Prince Leo.
They can't be reasoned with. Not because they're stupid, but because they are afraid that they are.
No, they only see. They don't see past themselves to the galaxy.
We have achieved our goals. Right. Where's the honorable member from Chandrilla?
That went well. The most part.
I suspect that you'll do quite well for yourself as you've done in the past.
Pantora.
I wish you luck as well, my old friend.
I thank you for your words.
I saw it personally.
It's something that weighs heavy on the mind of many Pantorans, me included. I lost some of my family members as well.
Thank you.
During the
stakeholder.
Purge of Pantora.
Stakeholder.
However, we hope that
your
in the future,
people are very brave.
Those who committed that horrid crimes can be brought to justice, and then our people healed.
I have a question for you, for the peace of mind of a man who I hold.
We will do right by you.
In high regard. He is a Pantoran.
Of course. What is your question?
The Balin family.
They.
Do you know anything about them?
When I was not in exile, I can look through my records. We also have a few refugee agencies as well, trying to document who survived or not. I'm happy
to look
into it.
If you could find something, I would be greatly appreciative for his peace of mind.
What did you say their name was?
Kosh Balin is his name.
Best of luck, Balin. And the Balin family.
Right.
Well. I'll look into it.
Thank you.
Very well,
hello, I'm lost.
Communication.
Let's get you the...
Oh, it's for here.
Alright, let's see. I believe the Admiral wishes to say something to you. He'll probably be here soon.
Lovely.
Oh, looks like there he is.
Admiral?
Folks. Chairman?
Admiral? Congratulations on your appointment.
How'd the session go? Thank you, Chairman.
Passionate, spiritual. We managed to accomplish quite a bit of on our agenda.
Well, that sounds great. I'm glad to hear.
Thank you, Admiral.
Congratulations, Admiral.
Hi, congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Very well. We'll remind you too, the confidence that our coalition has placed in you. Chairman Award.
Admiral,
we'll be on our way back
I
to
will
Nomad
need to be,
1.
Going on my own way as well. As you well know, we don't like to have all of Congress in one spot. It would be bad if the Imperials found out where we are. So I'll
if
be,
you could
well, alliance
send that information to Nomad
well.
1 when you can.
Of course.
I suppose it's coalition intelligence now,
fleet. I suppose it is, Admiral. We'll probably need to iron out all the details during a military subcommittee. Well, more paperwork
yes, of course,
for you
I may
now.
Need to, I may need to attend by way of hologram, but that should be no issue.
Yeah, that should be fine, Admiral.
Well, it's good to get this all
Gentlemen.
Hashed out. Safe travels
this
to
way,
you.
Chairman.
May
President.
The Force be with you.
And to you as well.
Alright, are you both ready to go?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Yeah.
How was all the politics? Not too much for you?
I, awakened a spark in me I thought long dead.
I, for one, have a headache. You know, that General
Me too.
Tag does not stop talking.
I wish I'd gotten a chance to hear him. Yeah. Imperial or not.
Sure.
I,
Fell Imperial. Triumvirate.
Aye.
With the same stripes that I did.
I would like to hear him out. I don't think my decision would have changed, but... I like to let a man speak for himself.
You're more than welcome to call him. He's very lonely and always looking for friends to talk to for hours on end.
I somehow doubt that.
Oh no, trust me, it's... Alright, we ready to go?
Aye. Leo?
Alright.
Yeah.
You alright, kid? You alright?
Just... Not what I imagined it would be.
It never is.
Yeah.
We'll talk on the ship. Figure something out.
Lieutenant, make sure the message that I sent gets the military caucus.
Force be with you.
And you, Chancellor.
Oh, you wanted your chance to talk to him.
Yeah, I guess this is it.
Safe travels and may the Force be with you.
General Tag.
A pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to you as well. Let's, In truth, I would have loved to hear you speak. If not about your exploits, then about all what you could have offered, but... Let me know in my vote.
Time.
Oh, I'm sure.
Our resources are now under Halsey, and we'll treat them well. He's a good commander.
I have no doubt.
There's no bitter feelings about this. I was invited to this. But I will say, be safe out there. It's a...
You as well.
...evolving galaxy.
That it is. I look forward to seeing...
Do you feel? Could I ask a question?
Of course.
What do you feel of the other side?
For the Empire.
No, constituents.
Ah, of course. I'm used to thinking of the world or the galaxy as just us versus the Empire. We're all in for the same purpose. We all fight the same enemy, and we have differing visions, but I think they don't have malice in their hearts. I think they speak for their people, which is what I do, which is what Leo does, which is what all of us do. And at the end of the night, we'll speak, we'll be heard, we'll be considered, and we'll come to a decision. That's how I feel.
You sound like Sergeant Horvath over there, but I disagree. My brother fights for Fang, but I still love him. I wish it wasn't like this.
My father fights for Fang.
You know my pain. If I could ask anything of you, the men across the aisle, topics like slavery, which I find abhorrent, but find it in your heart to forgive them. There are
problems. Hard.
I hate to leave it on this, but we shan't keep you. Everyone else is leaving. Aye. We don't want to be left behind, especially not risking our risk here.
Aye. I'm sure Admiral Halsey will find a way to let you talk my ear off somehow.
Hopefully at the end of the war when it's all said and done.
Agreed.
Halsey, always a pleasure.
General. It's good to see you again, Tag.
Give him a good lick, Halsey.
Give you the same offer I gave him.
And send my compliments to your wife.
I will. Shayla will, you know. And Prince, a pleasure to meet you as well.
Pleasure.
I understand that you find agreement with our side, but it's quite fine. You took a stand for what you believed in, and that's all anyone could. What I prefer.
Yeah.
They're good lads, Conrad.
Aye.
When all's said and done, you'll find some palaces to warm. We'll see you around, General.
I'm deferential to a town home or a barracks, mind you. But carry on, and may the Force be with you, gentlemen.
And with you. Stay safe.
The Force go with you. Are you a rock guy, Veers?
How do you figure?
Rocks, you know? Like this. This is a coral reef of composed calcium carbonate, limestone skeletons, and coral polyps. Been forming here for about 5 trillion years. I would have loved to have gotten a sample, but it's a security risk. We don't want to contaminate or bring anything home that could reveal this location, in case something should happen.
Limestone. A lot of the cliffs in Onderon are made of limestone.
Makes sense.
No, have it sent to the Dudani system. They need the food more than I do. Though some delicious scrimpies.
I was wondering who left this hunky chuck on my landing pad.
Tash! I haven't seen you in a minute.
Yeah, it's been a while.
Why have they got you pulling security for this event?
I organized the whole thing, actually. You know, they gave me these extra pips.
Oh, I'm not surprised. I don't know why they didn't tell me.
Looks like they made you work for it, sir.
Well, General Dash Troder.
Yeah, never thought I'd hear the name.
Me neither. I remember Lieutenant Dash Troder, a Brocking Buck pilot who couldn't even figure out how to start his turbulator. Same one who got stuck on the front kiosk of the hangar and busted up the rear end of that ARC-170.
Alright, squad leader. Don't have to bust me about it now.
Yeah, well, they might have given you the extra pip, but I'm the commander-in-chief now, so you'll always be under me.
That's right.
You just can't
shake
me.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
Oh, now don't go getting soft on me.
You know, second to me, you were still the best leader of Green Squadron.
Oh, second, huh? Well, you know that Green Squadron's got a new leader.
I heard all about it.
This one right here.
You got a hell of a
big boots to fill.
This is Prince Veers Lampar of Onderon. Group leader of Green Group.
Payment.
Onderon. That's a planet I haven't been in a long time.
She's got her benefits. Not for the faint of heart. It's a pleasure to meet you, General.
Call me Dash. I don't
like here. This is
good to meet
you. Do you remember the Prince of Altuin?
I thought he looked
like
him.
Yeah, this is his only heir. You probably don't remember him. I talked about him once or twice, but that was back when you could chalk his height up on your trousers. Leo Oranto.
Nice to meet you, Leo. Your Highness.
This is the one that's been working on that shadow cipher and was there when we busted in Trolla.
Griffin genius. Griffin.
I've heard all about you. Don't worry, I read the intelligence report. It's about all I can do nowadays with these bum legs.
You've got a bum knee or a bum leg for the last 30 years. It's
no,
always
thanks
a bum
to
something.
You. I still say you bumped the rear end of my X-Wing. That's what caused that
you
crash.
Know, if
I
you just flied a little more straight and level, it wouldn't have happened.
Well, what did you get? You got me out of your flying wing and put me in Special Forces. I'd say I did a lot better there.
Well, where are you headed after
this?
Well,
the stories this guy could tell you. I'm sure he doesn't, though. He's always tight-lipped.
Oh, well. Six ships.
Put that right. Don't you forget it, either. It's my motto now.
Takes a certain charm to get him to talk.
Am I interrupting anything, gentlemen?
Of course not.
Nothing special.
Well, Admiral, I would just like to say it's great to see that the vote has came to your outcome. And I would say that the people of Bothawu stand behind you firmly in solidarity.
Oh yes, I appreciate your confidence in and I have a high regard for the Bothan people, of course. Surprised that they didn't no offense. I'm surprised that they didn't choose to send one of their own as a representative.
There was a lot of turmoil. The Bothan people are suffering a great many loss and just, you know, they're just another chaos right now. It's conflict, so they...
You did good.
Thank you.
There's nothing wrong with being a compromise candidate. I know from experience. It may be commander-in-chief.
I was personally hand-picked, and they decided to go with me.
Well, you did good.
That means something.
And I appreciate your confidence in me. We're about to make our way out of here. It's good meeting you. Well, Dash, we're headed back to Nomad 1. Any chance I'll be seeing you again anytime soon?
I'm going with Papanoia. Me and him have been sitting pretty close together lately.
Prince, it's been
makes
great
sense.
To Have a great, great one, gentlemen.
Take care.
Whenever I'm back in the fleet, maybe I'll stop at the flagship. No promises.
Poor kid.
I mean, nice to have you aboard again. The old ship is still a mess. I might even clean it up for you if you come.
Well,
don't
worry.
Burn having the quarters,
sir. If you tell Ares I'm coming, he'll have the whole thing clean. That guy's a real stickler.
I think he gets his hair cut every 3 days. I've seen it.
He's a good boy, though. He's a good intelligence officer.
High and tight.
I don't doubt it. All right,
anyway,
well,
I'll let you
great
get
to see you again,
here.
Dash.
Yep. Bring it here, Commander-in-Chief.
General of Alliance Intelligence. Stay out of trouble, Dash.
Oh, carefully, get my bum shoulder next.
Me? Stay out of trouble? I'll be leading the next mission next time you get close to Nova. I got a job to finish.
Oh, by the living force.
It's good meeting you. I'll see you on the
floor. Of course.
Force be with you, Dash.
Meeting you.
Hey! Soul?
Yeah?
You still got... what was his name? No Way working with you?
That's right, yeah, he's
in my
attached
unit.
To Green Group right now. That's right.
I tried my best.
Tell him I said hi.
Will do.
Alright, get this thing out of here. The Imperials will be showing up soon. Well, who knows?
Yeah,
look, I got you!
Uh-huh. Alright, you get out of here. I hate that guy. No, I don't. Alright.
I let you get the pretty view out of here, Leo.
There we go.
That's only fair.
Ooh!
Good
gracious.
Don't worry.
Better than Hex.
Here we go. They're a new experimental model. I'm actually quite fond of them myself. It's a lot better than what I used to fly.
They don't scream as loud as I thought they would.
Nah, but I like the way they purr. They have a unique sound to them.
Oh, I was gonna say, so I'm...
Stand by. Sending.
Go ahead and
trace
this time.
You are clear to disembark.
Oy. I think they'll notice if I wave.
Welcome back. Where are those droids?
Look at Ciala.
He waved. I'm gonna do it back.
Hey,
Cap.
We have a crowd awaiting.
Yeah, we do. Everyone wants to see me dressed nice and pretty.
How'd it go?
A good condition. I'm a good pilot.
Shockingly well, all things considered.
Cute.
Your Highness?
You Admiral?
I assume the same?
Well, I'm not gonna say that.
Don't worry, Jordan. You're cute too.
I've got the image of Admiral Halsey in his dress uniform burned into my brain.
Does it
say
they got me to fly a snub fighter for the first time in 15 years and wear a dress uniform for the first time in 20, both in the same day. And for
honestly,
that, I'll never
I'm amazed. And Major Commander in Chief.
Admiral, command of the ship is handed back to you. I hereby relinquish.
Haven't seen
command.
Any droids here.
Nothing has happened on the watch. We've just moved positions and adjusted to. Outside of that, no incident reports and nothing. Sir.
Thank you, Captain.
Glad to have you back, Admiral.
Yeah, that makes you Fleet Admiral, right?
Sir.
His heels three times.
I think so. All right, folks.
I think that only works.
Let's get back to the regular.
Ooh.
Suppose we should have something of a debrief.
You're gonna have to file that in triplicate, like everything
hey
else.
Hey, kids!
Welcome back!
Yep.
Welcome back!
Hey, pop us home, let's go, come on! I'll give you the story.
Okay.
Story.
You wanna break the good news, Admiral?
Oh, it's Green Group. You're more than welcome to, they're your people.
Wonderful. Hex, how much did you hear?
Gosh.
How much did I hear? Nothing.
Nothing? Alright. What, did you stick by the fighter all night?
Hey, Kosh.
I missed the landing.
Yeah.
I missed the landing.
I landed.
Yeah, you did.
You did. It was awesome.
2 minutes before you
did crash this time. Deck place is feeling a lot better.
Were you on the planet at least, or were you just doing patrols?
About 3 minutes there, I was on the planet. No, it was an atmosphere with the patrol fleet looking for ants. You think we were just gonna let a fleet drop on your head without giving you a heads up?
Oh, no, you.
No, Kosh, what you're saying.
That's a scarlet attack on my character.
We'll leave the admiral to the bridge. I'll give you the rundown.
Okay, fine. What you say makes no importance to me.
Come on.
People haven't annoyed me.
You did ask for that. You asked.
Come on, boys. Oh, sorry.
Was it loud?
Blast! Was it loud? Yes, it was very loud. Is it? We got a lot done. We'll probably disappear every once in a while for those kinds of meetings. In the case of I have to run off, I guess it is. If I ever have to run off, Pell's in charge. You all know that. War doesn't stop just because I have to play politician.
I thought you were royalty.
Well, that's part and parcel of the job.
Hmm.
That's not weird to send. Well, I don't know, Leo. Do you think those votes are private? I don't think so.
I think everyone's privy.
We can play charades.
I'd rather just hear about it.
Well,
okay.
We as a body decided to combine the remnant fleets into a centralized command. We're a proper military now. All the remnant fleets will be coalesced with Admiral Halsey as the commander-in-chief.
Oh!
Oh, cool. Is that big?
Oh, that's great.
So that's very big.
Halsey will give him hell.
Oh, okay.
He's given him hell this far. That's
nice. And we have a Thel Imperial General who's also very eager to get to work.
Well, that's good. That sounds like experience, although he's probably ancient, ain't he?
As long as they're not on his side,
I
can't be as old as Hex.
Ooh.
Well, we made another big decision. We decided on the form of governance going forward when the Empire's done and dusted and we have our system.
So this really
no way.
Is a big...
That's huge!
You know, this really is the big thing, eh?
The big thing, aye. It'll, unitary system. We haven't worked on drafting the Constitution yet.
Thank
but,
the goddess.
I've got...
I was worried.
It was a discussion between a confederation and a proper unitary republic.
Ugh, boy. Confederation, we might as well. Authority.
Might as well start cranking out battle droids. Jokes aside.
Well, I was gonna say...
authority, the Empire will be back in no time.
Exactly. Well, the Confederation might as well just hand over authority right to the corporations right on the spot.
Politics aside, we made the decisions we made, and we'll run with them. Now, I'll make sure that when I act as a form of representative, I speak for the galaxy. And that means I speak for all of you as well.
Appreciate it.
And I got some words for you, Kosh. I'm not sure if you want to be public or not. It's about your home.
I'd like to hear it in private.
Aye. But the good news is, our speaker is Pantoran.
Really?
Aye, Chairman Papanoia.
Oh.
You sound shocked. You sound way less happy about it.
I've never heard you laugh like that. That's crazy.
The most rich and powerful family on Pantora would be running the rump government.
Oh, well. It'll be what it is.
Did you pick us up any souvenirs?
No, yeah. Actually, we weren't allowed to. It's a undisclosed location, top secret.
Boo.
Can't even bring off world.
Okay. That's what I. Okay, that's fine.
Hex, short version. We were sent as delegates. Well, you were Griffin with us, you know that. We made some pretty big decisions.
Leo, I want you to know after this, you got infinitely cooler to me.
Yeah, it was warm in the stars for us.
It's cool that you did that. That's big.
I was flying cover, and you didn't die. Yeah. That's my job, right there. Done.
Yep, job done. But, it went well down there. We got some progress done. That and, reminded me why I hate corporations so much.
Hate corporations.
That's a joke, mostly.
Yeah, it went right over my head. You make all this nice stuff for us.
Listen, you will not get me to say a single nice thing about the Outer Rim Ore Works Corporation over my dead body.
They're on our side, at least.
Meeting, then.
Amen to that.
Alright, that's it. That's all I have for y'all.
Hey!
Also, welcome back, Stillstrider. Took you long enough.
Yeah. I know you missed me.
I was almost starting to enjoy myself.
How about you tell your buddy to
come
back with one of our ships, would you?
I didn't know he was gone.
I forgot to mention that he took a ship. Yeah, that might be useful.
He sold one of our ships off to buy his back.
Oh, that blasted fool. You know,
Fan
I thought he was
going to
change this time.
I don't really know, but, this was a win.
Yeah.
It was. Alright. Leo, if you want to give some details, I'm going to steal Kosh for a second.
I wonder if the Admiral will see it this way.